Text field validation in SwiftUI can be surprisingly challenging because it requires handling user input dynamically while maintaining a seamless user experience. The difficulty arises from balancing live updates, error messages, and complex validation rules, all within SwiftUI's declarative framework. This video simplifies the process by walking you through step-by-step how to implement robust text field validation using regexes. You'll learn how to harness the power of regular expressions to create precise validation rules and make your SwiftUI forms bulletproof. Make sure to check out my Christmas sale, which includes SwiftUI Camp, a four-week bootcamp. Go ahead and check out the discounted link in the description. So today we are going to validate some fields, text fields in SwiftUI. So for that, I have just started a brand new vanilla Xcode project in SwiftUI. And what we're going to do is validate an email and a password. Simple as that. And then you will know how easy it is to just validate any text field in your SwiftUI projects. So what I'm going to do is just add in here two state variables at state private var email of type string. That's fine. And then let's see, yeah, password. AI is so amazing. So we have two state variables. We want to have also an is the form valid state variable. So at state private var is form valid. And by default, it's set to false. So let's set our view up. So first of all, we are going to have a text field, email, and then let's just bind this to the email. There we go. And then we are going to have a secure field. Again, bind it to the password. We're going to also have a button. Let's just have a button with an action and label. I prefer that one. So on the label, we're going to have a text of submit. That's fine. And let's just have also a frame of max width of infinity. Let's have also a button style of border prominent. And we are, yeah, let's just have this printed out, print email. And let's just also print out the password too. So password. Yeah, that's just perfectly fine. Now, we want to enable or disable if the form is valid. So disable if the form is not valid. Okay, we have set this up. Now, what we want to do is whenever we enter some text into the text field or the secure field, we also want to, basically what we want to do is check for its validity. Let me see the text field style of rounded border, and also let's add a padding, why not? So let's just create some functions right over here. So first of all, private var validate form. And is form valid? No, email is empty or password is empty. That's not what we are going to do. We are going to have also a private var is email valid, not var function, sorry, func validate email. Okay, and this will return a boolean. Okay, and then another one, private var validate password, and this will also return a boolean. Let's just return true for now on both of them so we don't have any issues. Okay, and then is form valid, validate email, and validate password. Really nice. Okay, so let's just build and run and let's see how this looks like. So basically, currently we are just going to have an email and password, and the form valid is set to false. Therefore, it's just going to be, disabled. There we go. And we may type if we choose to, right over there and also there. Okay, so the submit button is disabled. Really nice. This Christmas, give yourself the gift of mastering SwiftUI. I'm offering all of my products for iOS developers who code in SwiftUI at an incredible 91% discount. Only $199 instead of $2,280. Plus, you'll get access to SwiftUI Camp, my 4-week virtual bootcamp starting January the 6th, designed to turn you into an expert SwiftUI developer. Don't miss out on this once-in-a-year opportunity to develop apps faster and smarter. Use the link in the description. So how can we make sure that the validate form is being triggered when we type anything in? Well, we could just have an on change of email, and we are going to have an old value, which we don't care about, and a new value. Well, actually, we don't care about the new value either, and then in. We are going to say validate form when the email is being changed, because we're going to use the email right over here and the password right over here. The same goes for the password. So on change of password, validate form. So now whenever we type in, this validation will take place. So let's start by validating the email first. So we want to create an NS predicate with a regex, with a format, and then we want to evaluate that on the email. So how do we know all of these regexes? Well, there is a nice handy site, it's called regexlib.com, and then just search for email and password. There are a ton right over here. I just chose a one that I'm going to use for my email and one for my password. I'm just going to copy and paste it into my code in just a second, but feel free to choose whatever validation you'd like, or you could just write your own if you know a little bit more about how to create these regex strings. So let test equals an NS predicate, and we are going to use the one with the format and arguments. Now for the format, we are going to type in self capital letter matches and percent dot and at. So basically, you want to make sure that your test is going to match exactly the arguments. And what are the arguments? I'm going to copy this out. It's, at first sight, it's really a little bit of a gibberish, but basically, this is it. Let me just do the copy again. And you want to remove the argument. I chose the wrong test format. Okay, so this is what we want to do for the test. Now we want to evaluate. And we want to return test.evaluate with. Evaluate with is this one, yes. And then just the email. We don't have any substitute email. No substitution variables or anything like that. Okay. So this is how we are evaluating. So that's okay. Let's see. Currently, I just added it onto the password. Let's just put it onto the email. And then true for the password just now. So what we basically want to have in here is that we want to have any character from A to Z and 0 till 9. And then we want to add an at sign that, basically what email constitutes. So currently, you see the submit button is grayed out because it's disabled. So let's just type in dev, still not enough, at gmail.com. And co will also work because that's a valid name. So com, there we go. And we have the password, and password is empty. We're going to validate that in just a second, but currently email, dev@gmail.com, password, empty string. So now let's do the same for our email password validation. So let test equals NS predicate with a format, I believe it's this one. Yeah, it was this one. Okay, the format, let me just copy out the same thing. So it's this one, self matches. And then the arguments, it's a little bit different. So basically, it has to have some special characters. Let's see what's going on. Yeah, we want to test it. So return test affiliate, not with object, but with password. Okay, so basically what we want to have is some special characters A to Z, and then also it has to be between 4 and 8 characters long. Okay, let's test it out. But if you go to that site, you will have it's really straightforward. So dev@gmail.com. Okay, submit button still not available because we want to add in some password. So if you just type in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, nothing, of course. But if we add some special characters, let's have a capital letter, a small letter, another one, and special character, and a number. And there you go. We have that already. And let's just submit this, and you will see dev@gmail.com, capital letter, small letter, another one, a special character, an exclamation mark, and a number. That's it. Valid password. We may just go in and submit our, whatever request with the email and password. And that's how easy it is to validate text fields in Swift UI. Make sure to check out the link in the description for 91% off discount on my Christmas sale.